Thank you very much for inviting me. Thank you for that. It was the idea of the Permanent Mind of this NARC delegation bringing in this program. You know what this means, what I'm doing now, which is, of course, not only by the discipline, but also by the idea. I will talk about different to what we just heard now. So let's come back to Earth and look from here to a new horizon. I was thinking to take it very serious, what it means out of the box. Conference, I think it means first of all, not only to see new things. The first step of out of the box looking is to have a new concept of seeing things, a new concept of rethinking things we are thinking every day. And communication and media is a very important factor in the society, as this society is nothing else than its communication is life. If this is the society, so then we have a new way to define what society is, but that society is not something we see from outside and anyone sees it in the same way. Society is the concept, our common concept of how we act, how we observe, and how we think about our sociability. This is what society and communication culture makes one to one. We cannot talk about society and its change and its development if you don't talk about communication. We cannot talk about communication if you don't talk about society. We cannot talk about culture if you don't talk about the same time about society and communication. So those are different points of views for one and the same concept. And the concept means that by all different concepts we have, this concept of communication means we try to understand each other. But the question is how we are doing it and how we are understanding this concept of communication. And I would like you to think over that we might have a concept of plausibility of communication or a concept of plausibility of media, which is very simple. It's just an industrial concept. Sender and receiver, producer and consumer, or partner one or partner two, and in the middle of that is what we call the media. And we concentrate our competence not in ourselves, we do not find it in ourselves, we find it in the media, in the technology. This, I think, we have to rethink. Because communication is not just a tool, communication is not just a process. Communication is a concept by which we understand our own life, the life of the society. So communication science is somehow the description of the life of the society, the analysis of the life of the society. And society, again, is not something which has its own order and we agree in this order. The order of the society is as we look to the society. And as we look to the society, or as we look to communication, or as we look to family, or as we look to religion, or as we look to culture, all these concepts are, of course, developed in a long cultural program. And we are using this cultural program in order to understand. And we do not understand using the means of media. The media, is it the language or is it any media? The media is the system of reference in order to understand each other. And understanding each other is again something we have to rethink, because it doesn't make sense to say communication is the way how we come together, and at the end you think the same as I think. Maybe this is a totalitarian, somehow fascistic understanding of what communication in society is. Because communication is not the source of the same. Communication is the resource of difference. If communication is the construction of reality, we find we understand each other somehow in a similar understanding of reality. If a communication is the construction of reality, then it doesn't make sense to say we have to communicate in order to find to understand each other in a way so that we think the same. So then we would have just one reality. This is what I would call totalitarian. It makes sense to understand communication not only as a resource of consensus, we have to rethink it also as a resource of difference. Because you are thinking in another way than I do. I need you as a partner how to understand the world. I don't need the one who sees the same or gives me says he's seeing the same just in order not to have any difference. Difference is the motive of communication and is the source of communication. In that sense, we should be happy to have many languages, many cultures, many religions. All those systems or those orders are somehow an attempt to construct the world and to find a construction by which we can understand our lives, our existence. Talking about communication, not beyond this industrial possibility that there is a causal relation between a reason and an effect. This is what we, which gives us a model of plausibility, because this we can count, we can find out measures, we can structure it. But communication is nothing which can be counted, which can be ordered, which can be structured. Structure. Communication is a concept that reflects to the complexity of life, to the complexity of existence. Coming back to that, then we have different levels of understanding what communication is, and then I go there also to try to say what could media be. On an anthropological level, on a level where we try to find somehow a logical system of what does it mean that we are as we are, that we do what we do. This always confronts us with the situation that it might be the destination of our existence not to be defined. It might be the destination of our existence not to be defined. Of course, this is a pre-philosophical statement, but it says if we would not have communication in order to define, if we would not have communication as a concept in order to understand it and to find a determination or a definition of whatever, then we would not know what it is. We would not know what it means that we are as we are, that we do what we do. So even if we say, okay, my existence is defined by God, by Buddha, by whatever. So if we use a concept of God or a concept of Buddha, then this is also a result of communication. Of communication of difference. Your life and my life, your perspective and my perspective, your experience and my experience. What communication does is to help us those different experiences bring together in one sense. Because if we want to understand or if we want to observe experiences, we cannot do it in another way than to find a sense in it. And communication is not just to share experiences. Communication is to communify a sense of our experiences in order to find the second level, in order to find a way to explain what our personal existence, our individual existence means. It means that no existence can be defined outside of the experience of any other. The sociability of the personal existence means that I cannot define myself outside of of the knowledge than there is any other, the concrete other or the other environment, the social environment, the cultural environment, and the symbolic environment. If I want to know who I am, in any communication we have the desire to state ourselves. So this we only can do with the premise to know there is any other. This makes the sense of communication. So again, this is a sense of difference, and in this sense, it makes sense to communicate the difference, not becoming just one, but to come in common. Because we are different, we need each other. Because we are different, we need each other. This way to need each other is again the reflection of I need to define myself. I need a definition. I need a determination, or I need something, a destination. And on the third level, we could understand the concept of communication as a cultural potential, as a cultural thing, in the way that we have to learn to distinguish, always to distinguish, to make distinction and differentiation between big and small and red and blue, whatever. So to make the distinction is the challenge of our life, and the challenge of the communication. Communication is then the environment to find each other common because of difference. So if we are now living in a, as we call it, in a media society, I'm not according to the presentation. If we now understand communication, no. If we then think living in a society needs a communication, and this communication has something to do with the media, then we have to ask what do media really have to do with communication? Not by its nature. It's not the nature of communication to be related to communication. It's a cultural understanding of what media is and what media does. We say as communication is nothing which is a cultural concept, is a natural concept. We do not know anything about the nature of communication. It's a cultural concept by which we understand, maybe we understand the natural environment or our relation to the natural environment. But it's in itself, it's not a natural thing, it's a cultural concept. And the same is with media. We use media as an apparatus, as an organization or as a system, but it does not make sense to understand the media as the means of communication. The means we give too much responsibility, too much potential, and too much power to a system which is living from the way how we think it. So in this way, media, it might be much, much better not to talk about the radio or the newspaper or the internet, because the media is not the apparatus. The media is how to use the media in a cultural understanding. Is what the media, what makes a media is how to use the media. How are we using the media? This is the mediation in our society. So maybe it's better if we do not talk about radio or newspaper or internet as a media. It's better when we talk about that those media have a big position in constituting the society. It's better to talk about mediality. The society understands itself by its communication, and this communication is a medialized communication. It means it's a medialized way of finding ourselves in different positions, and because of these different positions, we are communified. We are communified in the way how we understand the world we are living with. When we were talking about today about education, Well, it, of course, education can be a process and can be a learning process, but education as well is somehow the way how I define my relation to the environment, how I define my relation to the social environment, to the cultural environment, but also to the symbolic environment, which means the media environment. And for defining, in order to be able to define this this relation, of course we need experience and we need a proof experience, so we need knowledge and we need science in order again to have somehow a common reference by which we can understand, and we need a common reference because of the different positions that we are coming from. When we talk about the media in that way, then it's clear that the question is not what does media with the people. The question is what does people with the media. It means that the culture of communication is the way how we are using the communicative structures in order to understand each other and to find a way of understanding in the way that we say we can stand to the different positions, to the different points of coming from, in order to come together and to construct a reality, knowing that any construction of reality is just an attempt to understand the world and is not a definition of a world. If we could define, we would have one world. But the world as a complex cannot be defined just in one order or by one order. As all things we are observing to never have the order by itself, the order that things have is also the order we are giving them as we watch it. As we watch it, for example, here, this assembly here, we are watching somehow, let's say, a conference. There's a special mediation we have here. We could not use the same mediation anywhere else. We would say, this is not the place. So the media we are using in order to understand now is the way how we understand the situation. It's the resetting that we are coming here in order to say, I'm able now to talk as I'm talking now, and you are listening as you are listening now. And in any other relationship or in any other place, it would not fit. So that means there's not only one media. Media is always the decision we bring with, or we arrange, or we accept how we understand that in a specific situation. So this is also then somehow a circle of reference, or an organization of reference, or a model of reference, which brings us together, and we know what are the rules, how we can understand each other here. So, if we then understand that the society is increasingly constituting itself in the model of media or in the modus of media, then the question is of who has the competence, or how do we have the competence in order to use the media in a way so that we develop all those values of communication we are searching for, the values of understanding each other, the values of of mutual attention, of mutual tolerance, of learning together, of sharing knowledge, etc. So the competence concept maybe is also used in a sometimes too simple way. Often we say you have to gain competence, or you have to build up your competence by learning. This is a very compensatory understanding. It means that do something more, learn something more, and then you are a better one. So this is all in the concept of the organization of the society. And the role model that you are the students and I am the teacher or whoever, or I am the doctor and you are the patient, those are role models They are not natural. They can be changed. They are just the models in order to organize the complexity of our social life and our social existence. But they can be changed. And they can be changed if we look to them not as a, as a, as a somehow natural items, but as we know, it is a concept. To talk about the society is using a concept in order to understand and to control and to observe our sociability. That could be changed. And if we then think that any reality we are talking about being constructed by communication, any reality is communicative created, is communicatively created, can be changed by you or other communication. And any reality is defined by the other side behind the reality, and this is what we call contingent. It means, in, as Newman said, something which is not in, not necessary, but also not impossible. So the society has a side, or has many sides. They are not yet developed, and they can be developed, and we develop them usually when we are in crisis. So then we think we should or we have to, otherwise we have no chance to survive. But maybe this is always the last point we do it. That's why I think science, this science of communication, science of sociology, or social and cultural sciences, should be much more sciences in the serve of crisis. Let us do our own crisis before it comes to us, let's say like that. Let's do the crisis within the science. So then social sciences, cultural sciences, communication science is not a science, and this is what we have to rethink as well, in order to affirm what we are doing, saying what is correct and what should we change in order to keep it as it is. No, social science, cultural science, and communication science, science that in this area should be observations of our everyday observation of communication. Because if society, if family, if religion, if culture, if communication, if politics is a concept of how we observe our social life, then we can change it. Then we can change it in a way that we find out the crisis of that we find out the crisis of thinking, and this can, we can do in a way what I call the observation of the observation. That's why we need in the is on the scientific level we need another language than the everyday language. It doesn't make sense to say, we know what communication is, our everyday, we experience it, we have just to systematize it, and then we know what's, this is just a pragmatic way. This is not a theory of communication. A theory of communication, a theory of society, a theory of culture, is to find out a model of practice that also gives us the criteria of the practice, so the critical points of practice. For myself, I'm seeing it like that. If we, we have a vertical line of thinking in between what is our idea of communication, what is our idea of society, what is our idea of whatever, of family, of religion, yeah? Of state, and what is the reality of state, of family, of culture, of communication. Those two points, the idea or the ideal of communication in media and the reality, they are in a dialectic relation. They are so similar because they are different. They are so similar because they are different. So that means if we want to understand the reality, we must go back to what's the idea of communication. We do it usually, go back to the idea of communication, finding some of a theoretical model of communication, saying communication is, and this is the idea of communication, in order to find it empirically or critically or normatively in what is the reality of communication. So if this is the everyday understanding of in this case of communication, or of society, then the scientific language or the scientific communication as well is not more than a construction, a construction of reality. In between of what is the idea of communication and what is the how we are realizing the communication, and the communication of the science is then in between of theory and practice. And theory and practice again are in a dialectic relationship. They are so similar because they are so different. We can only find theories in observing the practice with the idea of what we are talking about, finding out the model in order then to analyze the practice and to develop the practice in another way. This gives us then the challenge to change the practice. By changing the practice, we have then to change our theories, and changing the theories again gives us then an idea of changing the practice. So this is somehow a circle, but not always on the same level. It's a circle going up or down or anywhere, but it's not a circle just remaining in itself. If in this sense, science of communication or science of society, social science, is an observation of our everyday observation of society, of communication, of religion, whatever, then science is a communication science, I'm talking about that, is somehow the framework in which we could create crisis in order to find out those signs of reality, of society or of culture, whatever, we did not dare to develop, or we did not have the need to develop. So there's a difference in the thinking. We are used to an affirmative thinking, and as far as I understood this morning today, what we use is an emancipated thinking. Let's get free of what we think it is already called, and it has just been as it is. It can be done, it can be understood in otherwise. So this makes, of course, or this gives the challenge to understand that especially social sciences, not as sciences, they working just with accountabilities. We need theories, universal theories, integrative theories. They bring philosophy, natural science, social science, cultural science in one. And there's a possibility to do it. As we said this morning, we need a holistic view. As far as I think, the only holistic view of those things we want to see holistic is to make them being a concept and not an object or a subject. Let's understand society and culture and religion not as an object which we are observing from outside, but as a concept, knowing when we talk about society, we always are our own subject, our own object, because we cannot talk about society outside of ourselves. And if we then want to talk, for example, or want to observe another culture from one region to another region, or from one culture to the other culture, then of course we have to ask, what is the culture or what is the mind I am observing other cultures? And if I am then asked, what is the mind, what is the culture, how I am observing other cultures, then the subject of the observation is the culture of observation, and not the other culture, or the other religion, or the other world. And I think if you take this as an idea to rethink what we are doing with our science, then we have done the first step in order to